Creating realistic renders takes a lot of time, especially for scenes that need a bunch of 3D assets or accessories. So in this video, I'll be sharing with you my workflow and the tools to use on how to incorporate high-quality 3D assets from Quixel fast and easy. So before we begin, let me show you how I normally import Quixel assets into D5 Runner. Click on the Import button and choose a 3D asset model into our scene, and then select its corresponding texture maps individually. Now, that's time-consuming, right? What if I tell you that there's a better way? And that's what this video is about. So, let's get started. First, let's go through the tools required. We need the following installed: D5 2.3 version or higher, Megascans Bridge, and a D5 Quixel Asset Converter. Links are provided in the description section of this video. And at the time of this recording, the Asset Converter tool only supports 3D assets and 3D plans category from Quixel. Now, we don't have enough time to go through everything, so I'm only going to be showing you the installation process of the Asset Converter tool. If you have no clue as to how to install the Megascans Bridge, don't worry, leave a comment down below and I will create a separate walkthrough video for you. So, let's begin. Download the converter tool and unzip the var file. Now open up the Quixel to D5 application file. You will see two windows, one bridge tool window and the other a command prompt window. Just minimize the command prompt window and refrain from closing it. Doing so will close the entire application, so take note of that. Now, let's proceed with copying the library path from Quixel Bridge. This is where all of your downloaded 3D assets are saved. Go to Edit, Settings, take note of the library path, do a double check. We can see that there's a folder named 3D, open it. Now let's copy the path over to our converter tool. Go to Edit tab, select File Path, paste it here, and click Save. Let's download the 3D asset from Quixel Bridge. For this example, let's go ahead and download this beautiful rack asset over here. For the textures, check that you have the following items selected. Make sure that you have selected FBX format, your desired LOD or level of detail. Go to the path location of our downloaded 3D assets. Let's have a quick look. There you go. Now we have a 3D asset model in FBX format and its corresponding texture maps. Now, we need to convert our 3D asset FBX file to D5A format. Go to our converter tool and press Ctrl R to refresh. There you have it, our currently downloaded 3D asset. Select it, modify our export target and export settings like so. Now click on the export button and wait for it to load. Alright, it's done. On the lower left corner of our window, copy the new path value and go over to our D5 scene. Click on the import button and paste it. Click open. Now that's more efficient. As you can see, all of its texture maps are completely in place. This tool definitely saves us time by making our importing process much faster and easier. Here's a time lapse of the entire process. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, what do you think? Can you see yourself using this tool? Let me know in the comments down below. If you want this converter tool, check out the link in the description section of this video. That's about it. If you found this helpful, please give this video a like and subscribe if you haven't already. If you're curious enough to learn more, I highly suggest you watch this next video right here.